ceea ce privește programul următor și momentele următoare ale acestei seri, este decernarea diplomelor pentru cea de-a 8-a generație a programului Young Leaders. Pentru aceasta invit pe scenă pe Florin Pogonaru, membru al boardului executiv și vicepreședintele Institutului Aspen, și pe doamna Sorina Câmpean.
Mulțumesc! Este excepțional să fie aici. Este excepțional ce am văzut în prima parte. Am văzut români excepționali de astăzi care au fost premiați. Acum vom vedea români potențial excepțional de mâine. Este meritul Institutului Aspen că prin programul de Young Leaders știe să identifice pentru societatea românească elitele de mâine. M-a impresionat domnul Mihalcea. Este un părinte excepțional care, la un moment dat, spunea că se ferește să facă spovedania unui părinte fericit. Vreau să vă spun că, fiind unul dintre fondatorii Aspen România, mă simt ca un părinte colectiv fericit. Parte a unui părinte colectiv fericit. Este o mare reușită. Și dacă mă întreabă cineva în viață când am avut noroc, sigur, faptul că soția mea m-a ales este primul noroc. Pe urmă, preluat managementul a ceea ce a devenit astăzi familia Pogonaru și așa mai departe, dar În mod clar, am avut mare noroc că m-am alăturat lui Mircea Geană pentru crearea Institutului Aspen România. Și merită un rând de aplauze. Știu că de revenind însă la tinerii noștri. Cred de asemenea că în istorie, când se va vorbi de personalitatea anului 2014, personalitatea anului 2014 va fi tineretul român. Cred. Cred că, de fapt, este un an marcant pentru emanciparea și pentru preluarea destinului țării în mână. Și aici sunt două lucruri. Suntem obișnuiți și am văzut în toate primăverile de peste tot tineret care știe ce nu vrea. Astăzi, aici, la Aspen, vreau să sărbătorim tineretul care știe ce vrea. Deci, dați-mi voie. Să încep prin a citi numele tinerilor absolvenți a Young Leaders de anul ăsta, care știu ce vor pentru viitorul nostru. Ioana Ban. Zoltan Berețki. Thank you. Ciobanu. Doina Costache.
Our moderators, Juana and Juano. And last but not least, Todd, who gave us food for thought and a picture to remember for the decade to come. Thanking them for believing in us, first of all, and for offering us the swords, the grounds, and the companionship to challenge one or two intimate dragons, old or new. And each of us prevailed over a couple, at least, that's for sure. Now, our entry, our formal entry to the program was an individual interview, and the formal exit from the program a few hours ago, was a group presentation. So you may want to know something about us as a group. So is there anything about these people that makes them special together? And this is probably where the Young Leaders Program is so different from anything else. Because there are programs out there focusing on developing individual leadership skills. There are programs out there trying to make teams work better, more effectively. There are even programs out there empowering people to insert gradual change in their societies. But bringing strong characters together, have them bond and work together as a team, effectively as a team, in order to make the world a better place, not a lot of schemes attempt, because it's simply very hard. The premise itself rather resembles the story plot of a contemporary superhero blockbuster. But nobody's here to avenge anyone, so rest assured. However, speaking of superheroes, during the final group debriefing, the very final meeting that we had in our third week together, we were asked to consider what was our group's superpower, something that we had together over and beyond what each of us could bring individually. Usually these exercises end with a statement. In our case, this exercise resulted rather in a sort of a tacit promise. The promise to hold on together for long enough so as to discover this superpower. And I think we have what it takes to fulfill this promise, because if anything, we were the group who, in key moments throughout the program, preferred to take the risk and wait, consult some more, and seek further for some meaningful connection, rather than compromise on mellow, comfortable decisions just to advance the program. There are things that we definitely lacked as a group, but what we did not lack was a strong drive for shared meaning and legitimacy. So much so that in key moments throughout the program, we used old-fashioned voting to make a decision on what's going to be next, including who would deliver this speech tonight. And I'd like to take this opportunity to thank my colleagues for awarding me this incredible honor. Now, a few words about what lies ahead now that we have joined the Aspen Fellows Network. And we face a couple of really difficult questions ahead. So can these people come together and work together to make the world a better place? If self-reflection is any indication of an emerging group conscience, then the answer is yes. But will they, though? Particularly when no compelling crises are ahead of us, something that blockbusters conveniently abounded. That is more difficult to answer. As our two-day project is during the third week in Bukovina, at an elderly home in Solka, and the social projects that we're going to see nominated later tonight illustrate very clearly, the screaming crises of today's societies are more silent than ever. They require hard cross-sectoral work and a lot of dedication, a lot of time, and a lot of commitment. Furthermore, their resolution brings very little glory. So the question then becomes, what type of cement can bind the African fellows and any group of leaders, for that matter, to last together on such an ambitious journey. Our groups, our year's group, small contribution to the answer is that aligning motivation, causes, and talent is just not enough. If a leader is defined first and foremost by the strong belief in the righteousness of their cause and actions, then bringing leaders together successfully must mean something more than leaders just sharing respect and trust, however problematic and long-winding the road to achieving these may be. This meaning, then, has to extend to leaders believing in one another and finding joy in being routinely inspired by one another. Because every man's faith in their cause has its own height and depth. And it is particularly in times of depth when borrowing strength from the ones that you value is nothing short of vital. So after this fabulous year in Aspen, we have started as a group to discern faintly but surely the taste of this special bond. And while the road is very long ahead, what we have so far surely is something that we would like to build on. That's an internal joke. Thank you.